6 weeks after an explosion rocked Rubbertown, former workers at Carbide Industries are now raising questions about safety before the deadly blast.
Tonight, WLKY investigative reporter Dwayne Pullman begins his exclusive investigation, Burning Issues. And Dwayne, you've uncovered disturbing stories of former workers being chemically burned at this plant, huh?
That's right, and the stories are very disturbing. Now, the explosion caused many of us to question just how volatile those ingredients in the plant really were. But for those who worked inside before the explosion and who were burned by the chemicals, there was no question at all.
Smoke continues to billow and emergency crews remain on the scene.
In March, a massive explosion.
You can see where there is blown out sides of this building here.
Sent shockwaves through Rubbertown. A catastrophic inferno at Carbide Industries caused chaos and confusion and claimed the lives of two workers. At the center of it all, a dangerous raw ingredient, quicklime, and a potentially fiery finished product, calcium carbide.
Calcium carbide produces this, acetylene. Light it, and acetylene burns so hot, it can cut through metal. But you don't need this torch, or a flame. All you really need is calcium carbide, or that basic ingredient, quicklime.
Add water to either and you get a chemical reaction, a brew that burns above 1,000 degrees.
Once I stepped in it, it just opened up and it was like charcoal in the middle of it.
4 years ago, David Wimberly, a former employee at Carbide Industries, stepped off a forklift he was driving and into a hidden, fiery inferno.
And I looked at my boot, it almost melted. I took it off, and that's when I seen, you know, that my foot was messed up.
According to a state labor investigation, Wimberly, who was trained not to have direct contact with the dust, stepped into a pile of wet quicklime that was 1,341 degrees. Steam literally cooked Wimberly's skin off his leg.
It looked like barbecue. It hurt bad.
Wimberly was rushed to the hospital, where he received a skin graft.
That's a skin graft. From here to there, it goes all the way around.
Now, he suffers from nerve damage, numbness.
I can't feel nothing.
And pain.
I just can't take the, you know, the just standing up.
The state did not cite Carbide Industries for any wrongdoing, but Wimberly isn't alone.
Felt like my feet was on fire. I come running.
Adrian Wright and two others filed this lawsuit against Carbide Industries. In the suit, Wright claims he was hired by a subcontractor to vacuum dust at the plant. He says he had no idea what the dust was, but he knew it was bad when it began to burn.
And I don't ever want to experience that pain again.
These photographs taken by Wright's mother show the burns on his feet and ankles after the dust filled his boot.
It was like neon green skin.
As nasty as the burns to his feet and ankles were, it's the dust he says he breathed in that really worries Wright. While these internal documents reveal regular employees were trained and given respirators in high-risk areas, Wright says he went in without any protection at all.
You went in without a mask?
Yes.
When he complained, he says he got a mask like this one. Not nearly enough, he says, to keep the dust out. Now, Wright wheezes through our interview and struggles for breath on short walks. Wright has been in and out of the emergency room since then.
I'm completely out of breath. I'm about to pass out, fold over, panicking because I can't catch my breath.
The lawyer who filed the lawsuit on behalf of Wright and the two other workers says the company failed to give even a basic warning about the dangers in the dust.
You bring guys in there to clean it up. Don't you think you ought to tell them what the dangers are?
Carbide Industries' response to the lawsuit isn't due yet, and the company would not comment about specifics of this or any case. Wright worries he will never be the same from just one day in that dust.
What did they do to you that day?
They scarred me for life.
I tried to get a response from Carbide Industries. Instead, a New York City-based public relations firm issued this brief statement on behalf of the plant. We work every day to be as safe as possible, a spokesperson told me. We are doing an internal investigation to find out the root cause of this tragic accident of a month ago. Now, tonight at 11, we take our investigation to the state. Was enough being done to protect the safety and health of workers at the plant? Our investigation, Burning Issues, continues tonight at 11. I'm Dwayne Pullman, WLKY News.